is nothing but 2. Now, after that, we are going to just put all the value of LF equals to 600 plus 2B. Okay. Now, just determine the AF, which is the calculated area for the pedestal. AF equal to factored load by RMO multiplied by RMO upon SBC into RF. So put just the values. We have all the values. So after submission of all the values, just put in this formula to get area of the pedestal. After getting the area of the pedestal, it can be easily found out the area of the pedestal, LF and BF, and what we did in a slab base, which is very easy. The value we get is 8.9669 meter square. Just convert in meter in terms of mm square. So 8.69 into 10 to the power of 6 mm square. So LF into BF. So 600 into 2B into 400 plus 2B equals to area of the pedestal. Just put it into your calculator. You get value of B 1214.45. So I rounded it up 1215 mm. So now I have the B value in this formula. So I get LF equals to 3.3 meter and BF equals to 2.87 meter. Okay, so now consider 45 degree angle of dispersion of the load. Then the depth of the concrete will be 1.215. So this is what B represents, 1.215. Okay, now the main thing is this B represents the B itself. Okay, the distance between the end corner, the distance between edges to the starting of the base plate is also called as depth of the pedestal. So that is what you need to remember. So why we take the 45 degree dispersion of the load? First thing is important. What is the dispersion of load? Dispersion of load is nothing but distribution of load over a available area. Whenever the load acting axial load acts on the I section, it gets diverted to the base plate and base plate transfers the load to the pedestal with the help of the 45 degree angle. So with the help of that, the cracks, shrinkage, the cracks and different parameters, they are not able to deteriorate our section. So from that, we can consider 45 degree angle of dispersion of the load we provided over here. Then the depth of the block will be 1.215 meter, what we got it as a B value. Okay, so you can see this is a geometrical representation of the slab base design, where with this angle we have available with us, we need to design the slab base and the concrete pedestal. Okay, we have provided the provision for the cleat angle between the, like it is parallel to the section. Okay, that is inside of the section, it is ISMB section. Okay, this is ISA 100 by 100 by 10, which helps to resist the load. Okay, this is ISMB section, this is slab base, this is what is pedestal, this is B, what we call during the design of the pedestal, that is 1215 mm, and this is BF is 2.870. this is angle lug angles, which angles anchors, which is 300 mm long. Another corner we provided more too. So 4 of the 20 mm diameter of 300 mm long. So this is what exactly the diagrammatical representation is. Thank you so much.